Hey guys, Matthew here once again. I'm here on the 1 week Rampage / Beyond non-hardcore race. And this is my now level 78 early crit Buzzsaw character. So I made the video about the early crit Buzzsaw as what I was going to play for the 1 week. And I did just start that on hardcore. I got to level 43 and I entered a corrupted zone with the guy that creates lots of totems and kills you. I shouldn't have done it. I went in there anyway, and I died. So then I ended up starting just on the non-hardcore race, so I could actually get a feel for the character and the race itself without any, you know, penalty as such. And the character kind of turned out a little bit different, but it still works. It's a lot harder to do than I originally did it on standard when you have zero gear to start with. So it's probably not the friendliest first character for your league or race or whatever, because it takes just a little bit of gear to ramp up and the right gems and all that. So to start off with, I'll show you what actual gear I now have, because it's gone up a little bit, but it's still really poor in budget. This I got for a few chaos from someone in stream, Abyssus, because I need that massive DPS boost. And yeah, Alpha's Hell is really expensive, and also it's going to take more gear elsewhere to make it work with only a 4-link, especially some crappy amulet, pretty decent shield I found. That's probably my best piece. Some ring with some life, a ring with damn near nothing, some gloves with almost nothing that I'm mostly using for the 4-link, and some boots that just have a bit of movement speed and whatever. Also a belt that's pretty damn good, actually. I was given that to me as well, because I've been finding nothing. I've had such bad RNG. So with all of that, I have 6.8k DPS without power charges. I'm going to run a map and show you how it all goes with an Abyssus, which is a viable option as a more budget area. It's riskier because you get hit a lot harder, but it boosts your DPS a very substantial amount. So it also gives you a good chunk of physical, so my entire mana leech is based off of Mind Drinker. I'm not running Clarity on this. And I also had to take out my Molten Strike so that I could wear Cast When Damage Taken, Immortal Call, and Enduring Cry. So my Clear Speed has finally hit the stage where it's actually pretty comfortable. With 5 power charges, I'm running 8.7k DPS, and that is on a 4-link. And my 4-link as well, to mention, is, oh god. Guys, not the easiest one for me to kill. My 4-link, I'm actually running on a 4-link. I have Spectral Throw, Additional Accuracy, LMP, and Wed. I kinda have to use Additional Accuracy on this character, because I just can't get accuracy items anywhere. And that means I have really low accuracy. Without any accuracy gear, I'm at 70% chance to hit. With additional accuracy, it doesn't add to the mana cost of the skill, so that helps in actually being able to cast the skill, for starters. And second of all, it gives me a smoother playstyle, because I'll hit more often, that means I'll crit more often, that means things die. As opposed to using, like, crit damage, I have a much higher tooltip, but it wouldn't feel very safe most of the time, or smooth, even. So now my DPS is actually pretty decent. I can get, I can go through beyond mobs without too much issue. So even as low as 8.7k, which is pretty good for the 1 week, it's starting to ramp up to the levels that you can clear everything fairly comfortably. In the coming few levels, I will probably be trying it soon, once I feel a bit more comfortable with my gear. I think I'll need at least a 5-link for that to get Life Leech. Without Life Leech, it's going to be very hard to do. As you can see, I one-shot many things, as long as I crit. And my crit is at 81% with my 5 charges, with this fairly average gear. So you can see that gem levels, gem quality, there's a reflect. It's not too big a deal as long as I'm capped on resists, because my damage isn't that high. Anyway, so as long as, not as long as, to really boost the DPS of this character, you can see that you need good gem quality, good gem levels, fairly decent gear, especially in your jewelry, like jewelry without accuracy, jewelry without crit, crit multi, wed, all of that boosts substantial amounts. And it's just hard to find that type of stuff on the 1 week race. So this character, it's kind of more of a second character build for like the league. You know, you can absolutely still start out in the new leagues with this character. It's just going to be a bit tougher than if you had it as your second character. Because having a bit of currency to roll items, having a few twink items to start with, all of that is going to make it infinitely smoother. And having the right gems to be able to use. One other thing I haven't mentioned yet is I'm not currently... Man, these guys are really tough. I'm not currently running Anger because I just can't without an Alpha's Howl. So that's why I'm running the three auras that I can. Well, two Heralds and an Aura. And it still provides substantial enough DPS when I'm using the Abyssus especially. So really this is the demo of how I've gone so far with this character on the League. As you can see, it's turned out pretty well given my gear is worth less than an Exalt, I think, in total. I've been very unlucky with finding things. It is what it is. I've been fortunate enough that a few people have took pity on me and gave me some stuff. They didn't want to accept it, but they wanted to give it to me. And it helps just a little bit. But, on the hardcore league, it wasn't too bad leveling this character to start with. I got to 43 pretty comfortably. I find it too hard to not do the challenging fun things, like corrupt zone bosses, which I should have skipped, but I couldn't say no. So that's ultimately where the character fell flat. Or at least where my hardcore experience did. So this is what the passive tree looks like. It's still basically the passive tree I had shared with you guys, except I didn't go up here to take those because I only need those if I'm running Alpha's Howl and I need to squeeze Anger in, which I am not doing because it's just not practical with the 1 week league for me with what I've had drop. And I took a few of these extra life nodes to beef up my life because, as I said, gives crap. So it's just a small update on me in the 1 week race, level 78. Gonna push on a bit more in the last couple of days. Hopefully I can get up to a Tsuri level without much investment and give that a go. But I've had fun in this race and I can't wait for the new league. That's gonna be amazing. Hope you guys had fun in the race too, and I'll see you guys next time.